These craters became national monuments in 1962 because of their beautifully formed scoria cones. The craters are part of the volcanic system which reaches west into the Snæfellsnes Peninsula. Pathways have been created for hiking around these craters. The Vikings arrived in Iceland more than 1,000 years ago, bringing their small Nordic horses with them. Today, because of isolation, the breed remains pure. Strong and muscular, these horses are sure-footed enough to handle the roughest Icelandic terrain, small and gentle. With great stamina, speed, and intelligence, they are the perfect riding companions. Their colors are varied, and they are renowned for their five gaits: tirt, walk, trot, gallop, and flying pace.
So now they're going to greet us and introduce their horses, and you're more than welcome to give them applause. They will not get scared.
Pace is a two-beat gait, a side-based movement, so the front leg and hind leg from the same side moves back and forth.
We breed horses, we train horses, we teach people how to ride. We have riding school for children. Hi! Horse rental for tourists, and we also sell horses. So if you want to buy one later, we do accept credit cards. Part by showing us is tuft. It's spelled T. Horse has the entire weight on one or two legs. To give you the heads up, never call them a pony in front of an Icelandic horse breed. It's a three-beat gait, and this is their fastest gait. Look at him. The Icelandic horse is also known for having great temperament. They are generally very easy to train. They are friendly, and they're also curious.
While we're on the farm, let's see how the hay is baled. There's a lot of sheep farming here. A ewe will most likely have two babies. Then the cluster of three will spend the summer wandering free range, as there are no predators in Iceland. In the fall, they're rounded up and brought near the farm. Thank you. This area near Lake Myvatn is a popular hiking area through interesting lava rock formations. Supposedly, the Icelandic Yule lads live in this area in caves. Perhaps you'll see them at Christmas time. Husavik might be considered the whale-watching capital of Iceland. We gear up for the chilly, damp weather and hope to see at least one whale. By September, most of the migratory birds have already left Iceland. Iceland has many examples of basalt columns with unusual formations, but some days are so windy and wet, you just want to head for the nearest cave.